Namaskar. Good morning, dear students. Today's date is 9th July 2020, day Thursday. Today, we are going to revise Chapter 6, Malala Yousafzai's Grammar, Transitive and Intransitive Verbs. As you know, we learned this chapter with lot of examples. We have learned how to identify transitive and intransitive verbs. And if you remember, you learned these two verbs in the chapter 9th of your grammar textbook last year, verbs. Okay, in that chapter you learned about object of a verb, then direct and indirect object and transitive and intransitive verbs also. This year also you learned transitive and intransitive verbs. Today we are going to use both the year's experience to revise this chapter with lot of examples and little bit fun. Okay, so let's see what is a sentence. Alright, why I asked you what is a sentence? Because verb is one of the most important part of the sentence, which clears its meaning and tends to the listener or reader. Alright, so a sentence is a group of words that has a verb and makes a complete sense, right? What is the structure of the sentence? Sentence is having a structure of subject plus verb plus object, means SVO. Here, subject means the person or a noun about whom the sentence is written or spoken, right? Verb is the action word that tells us what a person or a thing is, okay, or what a person or a thing does, or what a person or a thing has, means verb is the action word that tells us information about the noun, its action, its ability, or the main idea about the subject, right? So verbs are very important. As you know, transitive and intransitive verbs are used to clarify the correct meaning of the sentence. So what do you mean by transitive and intransitive verbs? It's very simple. Transitive verbs are the verbs that have an object, direct object, to receive the action of a verb. It's very simple. Transitive verbs means they are having the direct object to receive the action of the verb. Alright. And intransitive verbs are the verbs that do not have any kind of direct object to receive the action of the verb. Means the sentences or the verbs which are having object to receive their action are called transitive verbs. And the verbs which do not have any object to receive their action are called intransitive verbs. Right. Before this, let's say subject-object verb. As Ruhi is eating pizza. Here Ruhi is the subject, because we are speaking about Ruhi. About whom we are speaking? Ruhi. Okay. What is she doing? She is eating. So, eating is the verb. And is the helping verb, right? Pizza is the object. So, Ruhi is eating pizza. Here, Ruhi is subject, is eating verb, and pizza is object. Alright. So, one more example of the verb. Okay, how can we identify verb? Mother bought Ria a computer. Here, bought is the verb. Okay, mother is the subject. And Ria computer is the next part of the sentence. Let's discuss transitive and intransitive verbs now in detail. As I told you, transitive verbs are the verbs that has the direct object to receive the verb's action. Example, the man loves his children. The man is the subject. Done. What is the action of a man? Loves. So, love is the verb. And who receives the action of love? His children. So, his children is the direct object. The man loves his children. Here, the man is the subject. Love is the verb. And who receives the direct action of the verb? His children. That's why verb love is the transitive verb, as it is having the object his children to receive its action. Alright. So loves is the transitive verb. Next sentence, the doctor cured him. Who cured him? The doctor. Means the doctor is the subject here. What was the doctor's action? Curing the patient. So cured is the verb. And to whom? Him. Who received the action of cure? The person, him. Okay. So cured is the transitive verb in this sentence. Next example, she crossed the street. She means girl, right? She is the subject. Crossed. What she did? Crossed. So crossed is the verb. And who received the action of crossing? The street. So the street is the direct object. So crossed is the transitive verb. Sorry, cross is the transitive verb. Now next see, Rohan kicked the ball. Who kicked the ball? Rohan. Means Rohan is the subject of the sentence. What was the Rohan's action? Kick. So kicked is the verb. And who? What he kicked? The ball. So the ball is the direct object. That's why kicked is the transitive verb. From these four examples, we got to know that transitive verbs have direct objects to receive their actions. That's why they are called transitive verbs. Means the verbs, the action that have a direct object to receive that action is called transitive verb. Alright, next, intransitive verbs. What are the intransitive verbs? Intransitive verbs are the action words that doesn't have a direct object to receive that action. Example, snow fell yesterday. What fell yesterday? Snow. So snow is the subject. What was the action of the snow? Fell. And yesterday is just a ending word of the sentence. It's not an object. That's why fell is the action word in the kind of intransitive. Right? Why? Because fell doesn't have its own object to receive the action of falling. Alright? That's why fell is intransitive verb. Next one. We felt. Turn. We fell. Here, we is the subject, fell is the verb. But there is no object to receive its action. That's why felled is an intransitive verb. Next one. They worked hard. They, who worked hard? They. They is the subject. Worked is the action word. Means verb. But there is not any object to receive the action of work hard. That's why worked is the intransitive verb. Let's see the next example. The dentist pulled out tooth. Okay, here the dentist pulled out tooth. In this sentence, the dentist is the subject. Pulled is the verb. And tooth is the direct object to receive the action of the verb. That's why pulled is the transitive verb. Alright. Now let's see subject and predicate to get more clear about the parts of verb, transitive and intransitive. Subject means what or who the sentence is about. Alright. As I explained you in the first part, subject means the main noun or main holder, soul of the sentence, about whom the sentence is spoken or written. Right? Subject means the word which answers the question what or who in the sentence. Alright. Then predicate. What does the subject does? The group of the words or the last part of the sentence which speaks us about the subject's action are called predicates. Right. Now Nagesh was eating a samosa. Here Nagesh was the subject and was eating a samosa is the predicate. Alright, now we use pronouns in the sentences. I, you, we, he, she, it, they. Pronouns can be used as subject and predicate objects both in a sentence. Means sometimes we use pronoun as a subject. Like she likes to play guitar. She is used as a subject in the sentence though it is pronoun. And one example, the doctor cured him. Here him is the object in this sentence. So pronouns can be both used as subject and objects. Now let's see, what do we use, why do we use pronouns? We use pronouns to avoid complexity of sentences. Raj bought the book because Raj liked to read books. Here we use Raj two times. It's unnecessary use of noun. Instead of using Raj two times, what we use? We use pronouns. For boys, he, we use, okay, for nouns, male nouns, we use he. So what is our correct answer by using pronouns? Pronouns, Raj bought the book because he liked to read books. Alright, so he pronoun is used instead of the noun Raj. Alright, now next part. Subject, object and predicate are very important to identify transitive and intransitive verbs. Whenever we need to identify the transitive and intransitive verbs, we should know the clear structure of the sentence and the clear parts of the sentence. Means subject, object, subject, verb, object or subject, object and predicate. Alright. Every complete sentence has two parts, subject and predicate. Subject means subject tells us what or who the sentence is about. Means the word which answers the question what or who is always the subject of the sentence. Got it? And predicate tells us what the subject does. Got? Done. Do you clear about the... Are you clear about the subject and predicate? Yes, I know that it's enough because we have learned it two times. And this one is the second time of revision. I hope that you all are clear about the things. Subject means the word which answers the question what and who in the sentence. Done. And predicate means the word or the group of word which tells us what the subject does. Object means instead of performing any action, they receive the action of the verb. Alright, object functions as noun or pronoun. Now, Sam ate a cream cake. Who ate a cream cake? Sam. Means Sam is the subject of the sentence. Right? Sam is the subject. Ate a cream cake. Here, ate means verb. Cake means object and ate a cream cake is the predicate because this whole group of word tells us what Sam does. Alright, what Sam did. How we got to know? By he ate a cream cake. So, ate a cream cake is a group of word that tells us the action of the noun or the subject of the sentence. Got it? Now, let's see some answers of the textbook questions. It will help you to be clear about your answers which you solved in your textbook. Now, rest of the things we will see from my notebook. I hope you all are ready with your textbook and pencil. Thank you. Okay. Underline the verbs in these sentences and say whether they are transitive or intransitive.
The little girl laughed merrily. Here, laughed is intransitive because there is nothing to receive the action of the verb. Second one, Pranav lost his keys. Lost is the verb. And who receives the action of losing keys? So this one is the transitive type of the verb. Let's see third one. The audience clapped. Here, the audience clapped intransitive verb because there is nothing after clap to receive the action of clapping. Fourth, I can't find my bag. Find is the transitive verb as it is having the object my bag to receive its action. Fifth one, the students left the classroom. Here, left is the transitive verb as the classroom is the object of the sentence. Sixth one, the water cooled quickly. Here, cooled is intransitive verb as it is not having any object to receive its action. Rain is falling on the roof. Here, falling is transitive verb as the roof is the object of the sentence. Eight, the boy hit the ball. Here, hit is the transitive verb because it is having the ball as an object to receive its action. Circle the objects in these sentences. The lion caught a deer. A deer is the object here. Rubina and Meera played football. Football is the object in this sentence. Third one, I heard a noise. Here, a noise is an object. Fourth one, the kitten hurt its paw. So, paw is the object. Fifth, Maya wrote an email. Email is an object in this sentence. They visited Hyderabad. Hyderabad is an object in this sentence. I hope all the concepts about transitive and intransitive verbs are clear. Now, what is your today's homework? Today, you have to practice transitive and intransitive verbs at home with the help of workbook, worksheet, and textbook. Thank you.